I'm Matt Powell from the Solidworks training team. This is the second video in the Beginner's Guide to xShape series where we create different components. Previously, we went over the user interface and created a simple chair. In this video, we'll be sculpting a donut on a plate. Let's jump into xShape and get started. I'll create a new component, enter a name for the component, a collaborative space to store the file, and optionally, I'll add a bookmark I created ahead of time, and click OK. I'll start by creating the plate. From the subdivision section of the action bar, I'll click Cylinder and place it on the X. Instead of adjusting the parameters here, we'll just select mid-plane and click the green check. I'll click on an empty space in the work area to remove my selection. For the plate, we don't need the two middle loops. I'll activate Delete Face Loops to delete the two loops. And click the green check to confirm. I'll switch my view normal to the YZ plane, reframe, and box select the component. I'll use a dot on the robot to scale the component in one direction. To see the component easier, I'll switch to a trimetric view and reframe the component. I'll use Subdivide Faces to create more faces to control. After activating Subdivide Faces, I'll toggle on Select Only Visible Elements. This allows me to box select only what I see on screen. I'll box select from right to left to select the top faces at once, and click Accept and Continue. I'll subdivide the faces at the center one more time, and click the green check. Make sure to toggle off Select Only Visible Elements. Now, I'll select one of the center faces, hold down Ctrl on my keyboard for multi-selection, and select all of the other faces in the center. I'll let go of Ctrl on my keyboard, and we can see the robot reappears. I'll use the Z-axis handle to move my selection down. I'll switch my view normal to the YZ plane so that I can approximate how far down to make the opening of the plate. The rim of the plate can be thinner, so I'll switch my view normal to the XY plane. I'll double-click the edge to select the entire loop, and I'll scale in two directions by clicking on one dot to turn it dark, and dragging the second dot. The plate looks good to me, so I'll click Accept Subdivision. Now, to create the donut on top of the plate, I'll hide the planes by clicking V on my keyboard and hide all reference planes. I'll also click Design Features on the Design Manager and click Make Translucent. Now when I create my donut, I can see where to position it on the plate. I'll activate Torus, click on the X to drop it, and use the dialog to scale the torus. Click the green check. While the component is still highlighted, I'll drag the Z-axis handle up and approximate the position. This looks good, so I'll accept subdivision and exit translucency. xShape has colors and view modes that can turn this simple model into a tasty looking treat. Under View, you can modify the view mode and visual quality. Under Tools, you can modify the color of your component. Looks good. I'll save my file, close the component, and I'm ready to create the next component in the video series. Thanks for watching. In the next video, we'll learn how to create a table. For more great content, click the link in the description below to access additional tips, tricks, and training courses. I'll see you in the next video.